It's with that mind that I have determined that we will close all K-12 schools, public and private, statewide, starting Tuesday, March 17th through March 30th.
Panic on the brain, world has gone insane, things are starting to get heavy. I can't help but think, I haven't felt this way since I asked you to go steady. Wondering, would you be my little quarantine, or is this the way it ends? 'Cause I told you my level of concern, but you walk by like you never heard. You could bring down my level of concern. Just need you to tell me we're alright, tell me we're okay. Panic on the brain, Michael's gone insane, Julie starts to make me nervous. I don't really care what they would say, I'm asking you to stay. My bunker underneath the surface.
Joining us.
Woo!
I'm Lauren, and that strange noise you just heard was Ava coming to you live from wherever the heck she is right now.
I'm in my room.
And tonight, we are providing a service to you, perhaps the most important play you've ever had the pleasure to witness.
More useful than Hamlet.
Slightly. I mean, who can't identify with being a prince and having the ghost of your father send you on a bloody path of revenge?
It certainly helped me through my recent family situation.
But could Hamlet teach you how to find toilet paper?
No.
Case closed.
Will this play show people how to get toilet paper?
No, but it can do everything else.
Where we're going, we don't need toilet paper.
I don't know about that. But without further ado, it is time for 10 ways to survive life in a quarantine. Ooh, can we do a cool sound effect with that, please?
We can try.
That's all we're doing tonight. Behold, 10 ways to survive life in a quarantine. Method 1. Fall in love with inanimate objects.
A great way to maintain sanity in these difficult times is to have a complicated relationship with an object. Let's see how Peter is doing.
Yes, I'm here. And I've been negotiating quarantine very well. In fact, I prefer it because it's given me time to spend time with my new best friend, Spalding. Say hello, Spalding. It's okay, he's shy. He talks a lot when we're alone, especially at night. But now that he's in front of a camera, he clams up. That's okay, I'll do all the talking. Even though we both agreed to be talking in front of the camera. I'm not mad or anything. Not at all. What's that? Oh, now you got stuff to say. But just to me, just quietly so I can hear. Oh, no, if it's important enough, say it for everyone. Oh, so that's how this is going to be. You're just going to make me look crazy in front of my friends. That's amazing. Anyways, Spalding and I have been getting along very well. We go for walks for the closet and then back to my bed. And sometimes, and this is really fun, we just stare into each other's eyes. Like this. It's magical. You're so beautiful, Spalding. Normally he says it back, which is nice, you know, that validation of your feelings. But he's playing hard to get today. It's okay. It doesn't hurt. So that's how this is gonna be, huh? I don't need you. I've got other friends. Meet Pen. I've been in love with Pen the whole time.
Great to see he's improving.
Doing a lot better. Let's check in on Bryn.
Hello, everyone. I know what you're thinking. What's her secret? She looks amazing. And yes, I do. Thank you. Well, there's a special new person in my life, and his name is Sir Lamp from the Kingdom of Lamps. He's a prince. You're probably wondering how a prince from the Kingdom of Lamps arrived in my room. Well, sometimes things are just like fairy tales, right? I sat around like a fairy princess waiting for my prince to come rescue me. And he did, although he's now quarantined with me and can't leave. But that's fine. You light up my life. You light up my room. You let me read when it's dark. And you light up my day, even though I don't need you to. Not everyone gets to have a special love like this. Most nights we read poetry to each other. Actually, Sir Lamp can't read or speak, which makes him the perfect boyfriend. Honestly, he's a good listener. So much listening! You're probably jealous now. That's all right. We don't care. Our love is going to shine brightly.
Okay, that seems like a healthy relationship.
I want to date Sir Lamp.
He's not very bright.
Those are the best kind.
And last, Lou is going to share how his inanimate object gets him through the day.
Hello, is this thing on? Hello, yes, it is me. Lou, you may not remember my name from school because I was always the one sitting in the back or getting stuffed into backpacks since we don't have lockers anymore, or the one who sat out gym class since he didn't like the outfits. And I have a special message here for all the ladies. I know that I wasn't on your radar. I know that I'm not the best looking guy and that you had to fall for Bryce, the quarterback of the water polo horse team or whatever. And yes, he's super nice and talented and attractive and all of that. But I have something he doesn't have. Oh yeah, this is the real deal, ladies. Four-ply, count 'em. This isn't your generic grocery store off-brand toilet paper. That's the last thing left on the shelf. Oh no, this is pure white gold. This feels like a cloud, or possibly a Pomeranian, or a cloud of Pomeranian puppies. You know what I'm talking about. And it could all be yours. This even had a picture of a baby on it. Why do they put pictures of babies on toilet paper? Babies aren't using toilet paper, at least no babies I've met. Are they implying this toilet paper feels like a baby? Because that's weird. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, am I right? I'll be taking applications for a new best friend after the show. Until then, dare to dream. Dare to dream.
I'll be your friend.
Shh, it's okay. It's over.
I miss you, Fourplay. I miss you so much.
It's time for our second method. Method 2, performing your own musicals with your pets.
That's right. You have co-stars right with you in your own homes. Use them, and you don't need to pay them except for with treats.
Ella shows us how it's done.
Oh, hi there. I'm Ella, and welcome to the most realistic production of cats ever. This little guy is McCavity, the mystery cat. And this one, McCavity is going to be playing multiple roles this evening. I have some more cats around here somewhere, but I think they're under the bed. Come to mama, Rum Tum Tugger! Ouch! He's shy. So, like, the other day, I asked my mom if we could get, like, 16 extra cats for this performance, like, no big deal. And she got straight in her car and drove away, and I have not seen her since. I'm so excited, because I'm pretty sure she went to get me more cats, but that was 3 days ago, so I'm beginning to wonder. Also, if you would like to donate cats, it would be a huge help. You can just pop them in their crates and dump them on my front doorstep, and I will take them. They will be loved and hugged and thrust into starring roles in this production. Now, as anybody knows, Cats is the story of the Jellicle Cats. These guys, they're crazy. Once every blue moon, the Jellicle Cats all get together to enact a live cat sacrifice to the underworld. And then the other cats just, like, go about their business for literally no reason at all. And they all can sing and dance, just like this guy. Come on, baby. Dance for mama. Dance. They're learning, slowly, but I have got this under control. I only need a few more months and many, 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 many more cats.
Better than the movie.
Definitely.
But Cats isn't the only musical you can do from your own home.
Sleeps in place. The dog who calls to me and licks my face. And do I pet again for his cute floof? The festival of the opera is there inside my room. Once again, give me a treat. My flute is over you and stronger yet. And though you don't always give me a treat, the fuzzball of the opera is here. Give me a treat.
I can't. I mustn't. I love you. I'll never leave you, ever. Now let me see you. You've been a dog this whole time?
Beautiful.
I want pets in all the plays from now on.
I don't.
And now it's time for method 3.
A big problem is keeping yourself occupied.
How to spend the time if not planning revenge?
Revenge on who?
You'll find out.
Jolene has some answers for us in our third method. Fun with scissors, or so much crafts.
Welcome, friends. I'm Jolene, and I'm here to show a wonderful way to spend your time in isolation. One thing that I do to manage my stress in these, let's face it, stressful conditions. Little joke there. I know it wasn't a great joke or anything, but sometimes it's the little jokes that aren't funny. That's where the true humor lies. So I like to do origami, which is the traditional Japanese art or technique of folding paper into a variety of decorative or representational forms, such as animals or flowers. I learned that from the internet. I find origami soothing. Let's learn how to fold a paper crane, shall we? First, take a sheet of paper. Next, fold it. Then you fold it again. And once more, just for fun. So much fun. Just an amazing, amazing amount of fun. And I think it goes like this. Whoops, not like that. That was a boo-boo. That was a terrible boo-boo. Just an awful, awful mistake made by a person who is failing at this very soothing task. And nope, not that way, not this way either. Does it look like a crane? It's a crane, right? This is a crane. This is a soothing origami crane, and I love doing this. I love this so much. Actually, that part is soothing.
I feel like I learned something.
I learned not to go over to Jolene's house.
No problem there.
Let's see what Pascal's up to.
All right. Hey, everybody. Pascal here, and I'm learning all kinds of new things in this quarantine, like how to hide from the rest of my family. And the best place to go is right here in the garage. And today, I'll be showing you how to build a birdhouse. A birdhouse? That's right. I know what you're thinking. Do the birds really need houses, Pascal? Don't they build nests for themselves? Aren't you just encouraging the birds to be lazy and, you know, not do their own work by providing subsidized housing? Think about it. You don't build squirrel houses. I don't see anyone building a deer house out there. Those other animals have to live outside like animals, and all of a sudden you're privileging birds over the other animals? What the heck are you even doing? You know, you actually make some pretty good points there. I mean, do the birds in the need our help? Those dudes can fly. All the other animals can't fly. They have to walk on the ground like idiots, and we're making houses for birds. Birds poop on your head. Do other animals poop on your head? No. No, they don't. Does a deer come out of the woods, climb up the side of your house, lean over your gutter, and poop on your head as you walk outside? No. Deer do not do that. Not to mention the fact that they're free, right? They can fly anywhere. It's like they're super beings, and I'm just stuck to the crust of the earth like a fool. They're not in quarantine. They're not worried about getting some stupid virus. They're basically running the show right now. Everybody look outside. It's birds. No people. Birds are in charge. And I'm supposed to make them a house? I'm supposed to use my time in here to create a home for a lazy, ignorant bird that can't even figure out how to build its own nest? No! No more! I will not build a birdhouse today! So yeah, I do my best thinking in the garage.
It's nice to have a hobby.
Venting is a great hobby.
My favorite.
Maybe one of our people can actually create a craft. Let's check in on Angela.
Hello, friends. It's Angela here with a wonderful painting lesson for all of you. I find that creating art is a soothing way to exercise my imagination. Just so lovely and so soothing. So nice. Okay, so we are going to start by taking our happy little paintbrush and try to think of something to paint. Try real hard, shouldn't we? Let's try to think happy thoughts. Try real hard, because these are difficult times. All right, so I think I'm going to start with a tree. So I'm going to dip my paintbrush in a little bit of brown and just start painting. Just a little stroke here, a little stroke there. Happy, 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 happy. This tree seems to life. Maybe it's in a forest. And maybe there's a squirrel in these lovely branches that lovely squirrel. But you know what? We can't see that lovely squirrel, and that's okay. Because that was not a mistake. Right? No mistakes in this space that are only happy accidents. Like me. Okay! So, let's just finish up some branches, and then maybe this tree has some leaves. So I'm gonna take another one of my lovely trusty paintbrushes, and I'm just gonna go right in for some green, because that's the color of leaves in my world. Maybe not in your world. Maybe in your world, trees are black and blue and red all over. They could beat a raccoon with a diaper rash. Maybe just trees don't exist in your world. Maybe you live on Mars. There aren't trees in Mars. But there could be. There could be, but there aren't. You're living in a crazy world. Okay. So, you know what? This is going great. It almost looks like a child made this, and that's okay. Children make wonderful things. But they're awful painters! Okay, so this tree is not a happy tree. Now it's a happy tree. All right. So next up, this tree. this tree needs a friend, so I'm gonna just start painting a moose. I'm gonna dip my paint in some brown and go and make a nice, nice little moose. Oh, look. Yes. See the technique. It's wonderful, and the moose has long legs. And a nice little bushy tail. Not a happy moose. Now it's a happy moose, and we know that because it's smiling. Could be from rabies. Could totally be from rabies, but it's not smiling. It's not gonna bite you. Yeah. All right. You know what? I'm just gonna really, let's go crazy here. Let's have some fun. Here comes a meteor to just to destroy everything. Yeah. I find painting so soothing. Yes. Fire, the tree has come up. Fire, burning, burning, burning. Watch out, you're not going to make it. Neither are you, moose. Oh, but plot twist, this moose has a shield and a meteor, but then the meteor. I've been told we're out of time. Now, remember, painting is very soothing and can help.
The imagination is a terrible thing.
To waste.
No, just a terrible thing. Let's see what else we have.
Method 4. I am good at sports now. No one can stop me.
Remember when you were a child and you thought you were good at things?
Yes.
And then you encountered other children and you realized you were terrible at those things.
Yes.
Well, now, without the competition, you can be the athlete you always had delusions of being.
For those of you just tuning in now, we've got a barn burner. The Liberty Monarchs, led by the all-conference Tash Johnson, are down by 2 to the Motorville Motorheads. It's been a stunning display of athleticism from Johnson, who scored a season high of 87 points, grabbed 42 rebounds, and recorded 27 blocks. I've never seen anything like it. I've never seen anything like it either, Dave. We're witnessing the birth of a new basketball goddess. This is like the first time I saw LeBron James, only so much better than that. She's the greatest basketball player that has ever lived, or that will ever live, or that will ever live in alternate dimensions. And here we go. Johnson inbounds to Johnson. Oh my God, the moves. The ball handling on display is magical. It's so magical. Johnson goes through the legs and over the head of the defender. She shoots from long distance. And Johnson grabs the rebound. No one can stop her. She grabs it again. The clock is counting down. 3, 2. One half. And that's time. We're just going to have to assume Johnson makes the shot. Oh my God, the crowd is going wild. They're storming the court, even though they're social distance at 6 feet apart. This is incredible. This is the most amazing basketball moment in history. I can't believe I was here to witness it. They're carrying her off the court.
I didn't think she was going to pull that out.
Shocking. I thought the Motorheads had that one.
They totally blew it.
I lost a lot of money on that one.
And there are other imaginary sports as well.
Here we are at the final table of the World Solitaire Championships. As always, the young challenger, Marvin Benoit, has cut a swath of destruction through the field. Imperturbable and so exceptionally handsome, he has had an answer for everything the cards have thrown at him. And now it's down to this, the final table. And here comes the prize money. The largest purse ever for the World Solitaire Championships. Just over $11.4 billion. Enough for Benoit to write his ticket anywhere. If he can only keep it together in this last most intense hand of solitaire. And the first cards are coming down face down as always. Brilliant form, really. The kind of spectacular card placement we've been seeing all tournament. And here we go. You could cut the tension in here with a knife, like a really sharp knife. Also an imaginary knife. You can really see the stress throwing the show on Benoit's face. He can't like that. Not a good sign for Benoit. Oh, he is in trouble now. This is a bloodbath. I've never seen someone go down so deep after just two cards. You can tell the pressure is really getting to him now. Oh, he is reaching into his steely core for whatever reserves of sanity and strength he had. One, two, three. OMG, I can't take this. I can't take this. Look at them all. Look at these glorious, glorious cards. I just don't see any way for him to win. There is no way out. Might as well just pack up and go home. Oh my goodness. He is using the tried and true method of solitaire players everywhere by cheating when no one is looking. Did anyone see? No one has seen him cheat, and therefore it is legal. And that is it. Benoit has won the championship. I'm going to Disneyland when it reopens at some point in the future. Woo! Also, I will be staying 6 feet apart from everyone else. So I'm probably not going to Disneyland, but I think about it. Woo!
I'm excellent at solitaire when no one is looking too.
You're only cheating yourself.
That's why I win.
But now we are on method five.
The plays of William Shakespeare.
That's Shakespeare.
No, you heard me.
Julius Caesar. Act 3, Scene 1. The Ides of March are come, but I am constant as the northern star. The skies are painted with unnumbered sparks, and they are all fire, and every over doth shine. Yet in that number I do know but one, that unassailable holds on his rank, unshaked of motion, in that I am he. O Seas Bear, hence! Wilt thou lift up Olympus? Great Seas Bear, doth not Brutus bootless kneel? Speak hands for me! Oh, I'm being stabbed! So many stabbings! I'm being stabbed! Oh no, no! Horrific! I loved you all! Et tu, Brute? Then fall, Caesar. Tyranny! Freedom! Liberty! He's dead! Tyranny is dead! Yes! But now what?
Those bears should have thought through that better.
Thinking ahead is not as stable as Shakespeare's characters or stuffed animals.
But it's not just terrible tragedies that are fun to perform with stuffed animals.
No, wait. It is terrible tragedies that are the most fun to perform with stuffed animals.
How about a terrible tragedy where everyone dies?
So, just to catch everybody up, Lambius killed Hootlet's father and married Queen Fertrude. showed up and told Hootlet, hey, I was killed. You need to go out and revenge my death. And Hootlet was like, that's crazy, man, but sure, Dad. And then Hootlet killed Bear Cheese, father, for no reason. And so now Bear Cheese is like, hey, man, you killed my dad. I like my dad. And Hootlet is like, I don't care, my dad's dead too. What? And then Hootlet's girlfriend killed herself because Hootlet was mean, and now Bear Cheese and Hootlet are about to duel. Except Lambius has poisoned Bear Cheese's blade, and he has also poisoned the cup too, in case Hootlet was thirsty. Simple! Come, Bear Cheese! Come, my lord! Pew, 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 pew. One! Nope. Judgment! A hit! A palpable hit! Told ya, didn't count. You missed me, dude. He just said a hit! A palpable hit! I didn't hear that. He said it! He totally said it! One. Oh, come on! I'm thirsty! No! Fertrude! Poison! Shoot. I'm dead. No! Oh, no! Oh, villainy! Seek it out! It is here, Hootlet. Hootlet, thou art slain. The treacherous instrument is in thy hand. Unbaten and envenomed, the king's to blame. The point, envenomed too? Then venom to the work. Pew. Aw, dang it. Pew. Oh. The rest. And pretty much everything else dies, too.
Well done. Greatest play ever.
I think we've had enough senseless death, though. Method 6, catch up on your studies.
Fun.
Super fun.
Hi, everyone. I'm Allison, and I'm here to help you. This is a difficult time for everyone. But I think the best way to forget about everything is to put your nose down and really focus on school right now. I am, and I love it. I'm learning so much. Yes, I have 3 little sisters that are driving me crazy. But guess what? I can lock and bolt my door and booby trap the hallway so they can't get at me. I just put my headphones on, dive into trigonometry, and ignore their little screams. Numbers are my friends now. Speaking of friends, I'm actually doing a special right now for math help. If you need someone to say, do your math homework for you, just email me and I will do it because I don't want to do anything else. It's math, 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 math all day here. I love it. I'm so, so happy. Speaking of math, I'm only charging $3.55 per assignment. I email the assignment back to you. You put your own name on it and turn it in as your own work. I offer bulk rates as well. 10 assignments for $32, which is a savings of 10.94%. Again, math, I love it. Also, May is my special algebra sale, 5% off all algebra homework. Look for more. One second. Hello? You're saying that's illegal and I shouldn't be talking about it online? Oh, okay. I did not realize that selling math homework was illegal. This changes my business plan significantly. Luckily, I've been studying economics, so I know that when something is illegal, it becomes a lot more expensive. Therefore, my rates have changed. Each assignment will be $22, and I will be using the extra revenue to hire goons who will enforce collection policies. They will be breaking their legs in a responsible manner. This is so fun. Seriously, buy now while you still can. I am your only hope. Without me, you're doomed. You won't regret this.
It's good to see some of our students are putting their minds to brilliant criminality.
It's really the American way.
But maybe someone out there is really studying well.
Hey! Thanks, guys. My name's Torrance, and I'm here to show you how great distance learning has been for me. Cause it's been a thing. It has definitely been a thing. Oh, so the first thing I do is I log into my email. Give me a moment here, just like a and right now my computer is not on speaking terms with other computers, so that's cool. But that's all right, because I can log in to access the help page that the district has made. Give me a moment here. Oh, and that's currently offline, which is fine. So I can't get to that. I've also forgotten my password, so I can't get a new password sent to me because there are a lot of other requests for new passwords or something. I don't know. There's only so much internet, I guess, and it doesn't reach my house. Oh, it's fine. I'm working through it. Mostly, I'm just trying to imagine what my teachers are trying to teach right now. Since I can't log into anything, or get anything to work, or get anyone to help me, or scream loud enough so that rescue workers can find me! So, anyways, my teachers are not assigning homework. At least, my imaginary teachers aren't, because they want to make sure I have the most fun quarantine experience possible, because they are very respectful of my time. But I keep trying. Kind of. Well, a little bit. You know, just the daily 5 to 6 minute effort before you call it a day. There's no use bashing your head into a wall over and over and over again, right? At some point, you just have to assume learning isn't for you. To be honest now, learning was not for me before this anyways, so I guess in a way, my teachers are not surprised that I'm not able to log in. Although, thankfully, my imaginary teachers are super chill about it. They're really impressed. Sorry. I think my connection. Give me a moment here. Low battery! What does that mean?
My heart just grew 3 sizes watching that.
The children are our future.
Terrifying.
Hey guys, Jules here, and I am loving life recently. Why, you ask? Well, just before we got sent home, my English teacher inside the best book in the history of everything. That's right. It's done. That's a drum roll. It's The Scarlet Letter by Nathaniel Hawthorne. Reading this book is like all the feels, you know. So many feels. I've read it 7 times now, and I almost understand it. It's got everything a book needs. A main character who gets rocks thrown at her for no reason, an evil child who speaks in tongues, an unhappy ending where the main character dies. It's fabulous. This book told me that every chance you have at happiness is doomed to be squashed by the patriarchy. And I am thankful for this heads up. Thanks, Scarlet Letter. I was about to dream things. Moral of the story, don't be a lady. They're just made for trouble. Am I right, fella? Also, check out my Scarlet Letter themed clothing. A is for awesome. Well, not in the book, but I think I deserve an A. Again, not in the book. Also, fun hats! You can see where it restricts my eye movement like a horse with blinders, so I can be focused straight and narrow on the book. Oh boy, this was the best decision my English teacher ever made. I am so happy with her reading choices for us. Maybe I will get to write a 5-paragraph essay with proper grammar and punctuation. This will be fun. I can't wait. Yay!
I love the idea of teachers enforcing homework through constant surveillance.
They are watching you.
Good thing the school district invested in those silent drones.
Which brings us to method 7.
Get really involved with the lives of squirrels outside your window.
With limited options for television these days, you can watch The Wild Kingdom outside.
Shh. Don't ruin it.
Hey. Hold on a little longer. Hey. Darn it! You're not there. But they could come back at any minute. So let me tell you about the latest updates between Kim and Kanye. It has been off the chain recently, so much drama. I can't even half the time. I'm watching and I'm like, I shouldn't even be watching this, you know? This is intense. I've been taking, notes. So, here goes. Day 1. They are so beautiful. Perfection! With those soft, puffy tails, they don't have a care in the world. Such a beautiful, happy home. Kanye goes out and gets the acorns, and he gives them to Kim. She loves him so much. Day 2. When Kanye was out today gathering nuts, a new squirrel appeared. Stanley. He's sleek and skinny like a sewer rat, and I hate him so much. But he goes up to Kim, and Kim gave him acorns. No, those were Kanye's acorns. He found those, and she gives them to Stanley. Later, Kanye comes home, and where are all the nuts? Oh, Kim ate them all, I guess, you furry cow. But Kanye doesn't know what's going on. No, he goes back out there because that's the kind of squirrel he is. He knows nothing. Day 8. Kim went out for acorns today, and Kanye stayed back. Stanley arrives, and it is on, y'all. It's like squirrel MMA in that tree. Get him, Kanye! Get that thieving rat up and down the tree! Ooh. Stanley will not be back. Mark my words. Day 9. Stanley is back. Kim gave him acorns. They are trash! They are so much trash! Day 12. Kanye is the king of trash. Kim went out today and two red squirrels showed up, Bridget and Jennifer. And Kanye was all about them. I have seen squirrels do things I didn't think squirrels did. I can't even with it. No wonder she was giving nuts to Stanley. Stanley is a prince. Day 15. Milo arrived today. Milo was one sweet looking squirrel. They're all falling for his nonsense. Day 17. I can't even with any of them, but am I still Team Kim till I die and then... Oh, who is this bunny sniffing around? This will not end well.
I learned that nature is not boring.
So much for short attention spans.
But if you're looking for a little more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, this stray cat fight is scheduled for a bunch of rounds until one of the cats runs away or an owner comes out to stop it.
fighting out of the bush on this side of my house, wearing the tabby coat. It's a notch-eared master of disaster, the ferocious feline, the outdoor cat of outdoor splat, Mongo the fuzzball. Fighting off the porch on the other side of my house, wearing the gray coat with black stripes. It's the menace of the midway, the scourge of squirrels, the yowler de fowler, Buttons! Ding, 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 and they're out. Buttons is moving sideways. His butt is in the air to appear bigger than he already is. Oh, and he's yowling now. Buttons has a fearsome yowl. Mongo is staying put. His butt is in the air too. His tail is up. Who will strike first? And it's Buttons coming in with two claws out. Mongo's in the air. Mongo has gone vertical. He is 3 feet in the air and appears to be running sideways while in the air. This is some kung fu that is happening now. And they back off. The judges score that exchange in favor of Buttons. 2-2-1. And Mongo's in again. Buttons in again. He is all over Mongo. Mongo rears back. He's on his back now. He's fighting with his back two claws. He's trying to break Buttons in the stomach. And Buttons is hit. Buttons is hit. I repeat, Buttons is taking a claw to the stomach. My heart is beating so fast right now, I am probably having a heart attack. But I will stay on my post to announce this cat fight. And Mongo's in again. He is in again. This is the end game, folks. This is the end game. Yeah! And they're backing away. They're walking away. This appears to be a draw, folks. We have a split decision. Stay tuned for the rematch.
Rigged!
Totally rigged. Buttons tested positive for catnip!
I knew it.
And now we come to the most popular survival method!
Number 8. Sleep, live in pajamas, eat chocolate, binge watch shows.
Or your weekend is now your life.
Greetings, followers. It is I, Lynn, your style guru. I know you've been anxiously awaiting my special quarantine fashion looks, and I want to let you all know that you're all in my heart. All of you. I couldn't be the influencer I am without your devoted and creepy support. Seriously, some of you people need to get a life. But that's what I'm here for, to have a life for you, to show the kind of life a really attractive person has. It's so much better than yours. I don't mind your jealousy. I thrive on it. I'm broadcasting today from my couch, which was made from some type of fabric and was purchased at an exclusive store for couches. The store is so exclusive, they probably wouldn't even let you in. It's also most quite likely closed at the moment. But still, when I feel this couch, I know it's special and beautiful. Like me, and not like you. Also with me today, I have this designer blanket. Oh, and these designer chocolates. I also have designer potato chips. Perfect for picturesque lounging and bespoke snacking. Oh, today I'm resplendent in cow pajamas, which I have worn for the last 11 days. This particular set of pajamas was made by people in the pajama industry. I like to imagine them, as they do whatever they do to make pajamas, they're hoping that someone like me would wear them someday. It was probably their dream. They don't have big dreams, most likely. I hope that someday an influencer will wear these pajamas. You just got your wish, pajama craftsman. You're welcome. I have fulfilled your tiny dreams. Oh, and finally, I'm wearing slippers. They're very far away from me at the moment, so I don't know who crafted them. But I can just say that my toes are toasty, as if they were being hugged by a very obese cat. Be sure to tune in tomorrow while I will be wearing the exact same thing and sitting in the exact same spot.
That was inspirational.
I feel like I'm a better person now.
Speaking of inspirational.
Yo, I am here to help you with physical fitness. Sorry, hold on. It took a second to vocalize like that. All right, second wind. Woo! Are you ready to transform your body and your mind? Don't answer that. I don't need to know. I'm just going to assume the answer is yes, Toby. All right, then. Ready? I want you to take your weights. First, mentally prepare yourself for what you're about to do. Breathe in. Breathe out. That's right. Loosen those muscles. All right then. Ready? One, two, three. Release. And one, two, three. Release. And one, two, three. Release. Oh, my sweet fluffy kitty. This is difficult. Release. And one, two, three. Release. Fight through the pain. I know you can do this. Ah! And one, two, three. Release. You did it! And now for the reclined chip press. Take your weight. And one, two, three. I love all you guys!
Stunning.
I feel like these exercises were made for me.
I was made for this. This is my moment to shine. Because I've been preparing for this my entire life. Saturday mornings, I don't even think about getting out of bed before 2 in the afternoon. And even then, I just make my way to the fridge, get something to eat, and then go back to my bed and have my breakfast. It's how I roll. Most days, I don't change my clothes. I shower on Tuesdays. So let me lay it out for all of you newbies out there. First, you're gonna wanna make sure that you have a stash of batteries near you for your remote controls. Nothing is worse than having to actually get up to get new batteries for your remotes. That is a nightmare no one wants to see, honestly. I also suggest having duplicate remotes in case you lose the first one in some type of cushiony place. Anyways, I know that not everybody is on that level, but I have 4 identical remotes in this room right now. They all work the TV. They can all handle Netflix. Next, you want to consider your comfort level, which is key. Mine is currently set to Jell-O, which is, I want to feel like I'm submerged in Jell-O. I want no pressure on my limbs at all and just hang there suspended in a pillowy lime green emulsion. If you have zippers on your clothes, you are doing this wrong. Also important, how much food do you have in your room right now? Double it, then double it again. Check it, I've got so much food in this room. I don't even know where it is. I roll over, crush something. That goes into the mouth. Safest place for your snacks is in your stomach. Most important of all, do not lose hope. You can achieve supreme laziness with a little bit of effort. Remember, it only takes a little bit of effort now to make sure you never have to make any effort again. Peace. I'm going to bed.
She gives me hope.
We can get through this if we just don't do much.
Exactly.
But if you do want to do something, there's Method 9. Spooky stories!
When we set out, we didn't know if we were going to make it back. Our supplies were running low. We had no choice. No choice. There were rumors that you could get what you wanted, but only if you waited in line. And finally, you were given a shopping cart and you were let into the Costco. But every so often, you could hear if you listened hard enough. Squeak! 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 You'd stop. Nothing. You'd walk again. Squeak! 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 I realized it was a squeaky wheel on our cart. There was no way to go back for a new cart. It was pulling me to the side. I had to fight it. There was no choice. It was pulling and pulling. Where was it taking me? To the paper, good Sile. And that was when I saw one single package of toilet paper. I reached out my hand. Do I dare take it? Why was it left here? Is it cursed? I reached out to take it, the one package no one had wanted, and that was when I heard, Rachel. I stopped, I looked around. No one was near me. Rachel. I looked around again. No one was near me. Where was it coming from? Rachel. I was coming from inside the toilet paper package! But I took it anyway, because I mean, it's toilet paper, am I right? But every so often, when I'm in the bathroom, I hear, squeak, squeak, I'm single ply.
Or you could try a different oral tradition.
I don't want to.
Speak, memory of the cunning hero. The dog walker blown off course time and again by the cruel whims of fate. Speak of Maya, the chosen one, after she was asked by her mother to take Furry Gomer on a walk through the neighborhood. Speak of her failure to find a decent excuse and cry, oh heavens, that it was also a little bit cold that day. Of these things, I shall now sing. O muse, recall that Gomer pees a lot on every bush, on every tree, on every place. Another dog has peed before him. And the sniffing, the most profound sniffing of many things. So profound the sniffing that no matter how strenuously brave Maya pulled on the leash, Furry Gomer would not be moved. Speak of the contemptible squirrels that mocked the beast that Maya struggled to control with their chittering, like the sigh of 10,000 little teeth and their little noses and their little tails. Mighty was the wrath that Gomer faced. Like the thunderous earthquake summoned by Poseidon, Gomer chased his long-tailed nemesis. But alas, alas, he could not reach them. Speak, too, of the social distancing that Maya had to do on sidewalks narrow as a ribbon. How she nimbly dodged small children on razor scooters. And how she fought to keep Furry Gomer from sniffing the rear ends of many hounds. So many rear ends of so many hounds. And last, speak of the great calamity that befell her. Speak of the thunderous dropping from well-fed Gomer. And memory, failure to remember to bring a poop bag. Tragic. Luckily, brave Maya ran away very, very quickly.
That epic will be passed down for generations.
Also, if you found Maya's evidence, you can find her at...
And our last representative of the oral tradition, the tragedy.
This is a pre-recorded message. If you see this, don't try to contact me. Don't call me. Don't text me. Because my mom is taking my phone. I don't know how long she's going to keep it for. I guess this is some kind of punishment. I said, take my legs instead. I don't even need two of those. But she wouldn't listen to reason. She's gone mad, I tell you. Mad! All right, so I may have locked my little brother in the basement with a live rat. I may have done that. And I may have told him I hired child kidnappers off the internet that were going to stuff him in a trash bag and take him to a remote island. I might have said that. Those words might have come out of my mouth. But who has control over the things they say? Not me, obviously. I can't be expected to take responsibility for the things I say. What's next? They punish me for the things I threaten to do and don't even do all the way? I can see my phoneless future now. A barren wasteland with no communication to the outside world. Except the landline. I don't even know how to use a landline. How will I know what's going on in the world? I won't know. It's just too terrible to contemplate. I might have to read a book or talk to people just to pass the time. The end is near, my friends. The end. I'll probably get it back sometime tomorrow, but I don't know how I'll survive until then.
Thoughts and prayers in this difficult time.
Thoughts and prayers, Anya.
Of course, of all the methods, there is one that is guaranteed to be the most effective to deal with life in quarantine.
Megalomania!
That's right. The belief that you are the one and true absolute center of the universe is a great way to deal with crisis.
Let's take a look.
Welcome to the kingdom of Jeff. It is I, Supreme Commander, High Overlord, and Ruler for Life. Jeff. Bow before me. Yes, I feel your obedience to my will. Good. At this moment, I would like to draw your attention to some new developments in the kingdom of Jeff. From the city of Jeffetropolis, today is Jeff Appreciation Day. Have you told me how much you love me today? Have you? Well, I want to be clear that I'm no longer in need of the validation of others. I am beyond all that now. There is only Jeff. One moment. Mom, I'm busy. No, I am not taking out the garbage. Do you know who you're talking to? I am Jeff, High Overlord of the... Mom, stop it. Duh, fine. The kingdom of Jeff is threatened. But the kingdom of Jeff is strong and will never surrender to the enemy. We are Jeff. At this moment, I would like to read the new proclamations passed on by the Assembly of Jeff, of which I am 12 of the 13 members, the 13th being Mr. Puppers. Mr. Puppers had some thoughts in the committee, but he was clearly outvoted and now is being investigated as a traitor to the kingdom. Who do you work for, Mr. Puppers? Who do you work for? Speak! We have ways of making you talk. You'll regret this. Let this be a lesson to any other potential traitors out there. Ask not what Jeff can do for you. Ask what you can do for your Jeff. Your kingdom requires obedience and sacrifice. Learn the lesson of Mr. Puppers traitors! Your leader needs a moment. Just remember that I am infallible and only believe me. Do not believe the lies of Mr. Puppers.
Seems healthy.
He's gonna come out of this okay.
Like someone else I know.
Yes, my children. Bask in my aura, drink from my immortal energy. I, Ashley, shall hear your prayers. Fear not, my child. I, Ashley, shall watch over you in these difficult times. Now return to your people. Oh, hello. You're probably wondering why my stuffed animals are worshiping me like a yoga cult yoga instructor. Well, it happened organically, actually. Flashback. You're so nice, Ashley. Oh,
Well, thank you, Jojo. And you're very cute. Oh, well, thank you, Mittens.
I think you're tops, Ashley.
Well, yes, I mean, I think that you're the best human in the world, Ashley. Oh, well, I guess,
I would die for you.
I would kill for you.
I would lay down my meaningless life if you raised a finger.
Well, I would give up my firstborn child for her.
I would give up everybody's firstborn children. We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
Yeah, so it happened in a natural succession. Some of the stuffed animals refused the new, training. But, you know, they'll come around eventually. And a boop.
Okay, but this should be a time of celebration.
How so?
Well, watch.
Hi, everybody. It's my birthday. It's me, your favorite friend, Karen, who you didn't talk to all that much. And I sent out the invitations for my birthday party. And I guess no one wanted to risk their lives to come out here and celebrate my entrance into the world. So that's fine. That's totally fine. I don't need you to come over on my very special day that only happens once a year. It's totally meaningless, right? But I'm dealing with it, and I'm throwing a party for myself. Because there's one person in the world you can trust will love you through anything, and that's yourself. Yay, me! Happy birthday to me. Woo! Yeah! Let's see what I got me for my birthday. I have no idea what this is. You shouldn't have me. Hey, Karen, it's your birthday. I spared no expense. Thank you, me. It's my cell phone, and it already has all of your contacts and photos in it. You know me so well, me. Yeah, I always know. You really do. Unlike all those other people out there who didn't even show up for your birthday party. Oh, come on now, me. I'm sure that's not true. I know there's a lot of people out there who want to support me on their birthday. They probably just sent their presents through the mail. Right? You probably sent your present through the mail. I'm sure they're on their way right now. Aren't they? Let's see what else I got me. I wonder what's in here. Open it, open it, open it, open it, open it. Okay. If you insist. Is it, it's money? So much money. All the money I have in the world is yours now. Oh my gosh. That is so amazing. Thank you. Thank you. So much, me. And I'm sure all the amazing people out there sent me money too, right? I'm sure they're mailing it to me right now. Lots and lots of birthday money. Lots and lots of it. Because that's just what good friends would do. Well, it's a good thing you stole their credit card information from the files at school, huh? Shh. They're gonna be so surprised. Well, that's the best part about birthday parties, isn't it? Surprises.
Well, it looks like everybody needs to call their credit card companies.
So really, the last method is steal?
No. It's just ask for gifts, forcefully, if need be.
I see.
Well, that's all the time we have. Wash your hands and your pets and small children and birds that fly into your house.
Thanks for joining us. This has been
10 Ways to Survive Life in a Quarantine.
Great, it starts with an earthquake, birds and snakes, an airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. I have a hurricane, listen to yourself, turn world, turns its own needs, dummies. and burn, return. Listen to yourself churn. Locking in, uniform and book burning, blood letting. Every motive escalate, automotive centering. Light a candle, light a motor, step down, step down. Watching heel crush, crush, uh-oh. This means no fear, cavalier, renegade, steer clear. A tournament of lies. Offer me solutions, offer me alternatives, and I decline. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. I feel fine. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. The other night I drifted nice, continental drifted by mountains. Bernstein, Leonid, Brezhnev, Lenny, Bush, and Lester Banks. Birthday party, cheesecake, jelly bean, boom. New symbiotic, patriotic, slam, button, nap. Right?
Right.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it.